from wisconsingarden.net. Well, today I was trimming my tomatoes, taking all the suckers off of them. That's something you want to do because the suckers just do that. They suck out the life of your plant. So as I'm going through, taking out the branches where the stem of the branch and the leaf, and right in that little valley there, that's where the suckers grow. And you want to keep pinching them out because they will continue to grow. Get those out of there. Remove them from your tomato bed. Put them far away. Throw them in the garbage. And as I was doing that, I noticed that this particular plant had white flies. Now, some of this is cottonwood, but there are white flies on here, and you can see them right here. And what they do is they suck out the juices of your tomato. And here I'm seeing a sucker right here. Here's a sucker if you want to see what that is. So you just, usually you can just bend them out. Bend them back and forth and they come out. So I ran to my Jerry Baker book, What Do I Do with White Flies on My Tomatoes? And he said the quickest thing was take a handheld vacuum and just vacuum your plant. Of course, then you have to throw your vacuum cleaner bag away, or you have to somehow get rid of all of those. Well, I didn't want to do that. And the other thing was to just spray them with water and then they fall down to the ground. Well, that's okay. But his other suggestion was to get something bright yellow because they are attracted to yellow. And I didn't have anything but a white piece of cardboard, so I sprayed it yellow and then I put a layer of petroleum jelly on there. And they are such fine winged creatures, they're attracted to it and they get stuck on it. And they die. So we'll see how that goes. I'm sure it wouldn't hurt the plant that much because there weren't that many and they will probably run through their life cycle and then be gone. But I don't want them spreading, so I did. The other thing I was doing today was adding another ring of powdered milk around the base of each plant. And you do that to prevent fungus and viruses. And you do it every couple of weeks. This is the first time I've done it since I planted them. So it was time. Because now it's the beginning of July. So now they're all sucker-free. They've got their milk, and yesterday I watered them really well, so we should be good to go for a while. Yesterday, Rick had the first tomato. It was a little, not quite ripe yet, and today I had a tomato, and there's one more. You see it in there? And I'm picking it. Look at that. Perfect little tomato. And this is a sweet 100. So the sweet 100s were the very first ones to make. So with my green little tomato hands, I'm going to eat it. Almost as good as a strawberry. Just bursts open in your mouth. Good. It's all worth it. So now I have to go do my other garden.